right, everybody. Welcome to another Sun King Studio 92 session powered by Klipsch speakers and headphones. And we are proud to welcome Michael McDermott, who's in town playing for Concerts for a Cause this weekend. Michael McDermott, welcome to Sun King Studio 92. Let's give him a hand.
Thank you. This town. Whoa, I'm so sick of this town. Why the hell are we still hanging around? Whoa, I'm so sick of this town. Whoa, I'm so sick of this place. Whoa, I'm so sick of this place. Well, my dreams, they seem to go to waste. Whoa, I'm so sick of this place. Now, I don't know what it is that I've been waiting for. And I don't know why it is I stayed so long. They say people get the lies that they settle for. But all I see are the reminders of how it all went wrong. Sick of this town. Whoa, I'm so sick of this town. Another mom and pop shop closing down. Whoa, I'm so sick of this town. Each year it's more or less the same. Strip malls, bar brawls, football games. Around here we love to sit and blame. It seems such an awful shame. So be careful of the past, don't let it drag you down. There's no shame in all the things you might regret. And beware of all the ghosts that love to hang around. They're just there to remind you of what you're trying to forget. You see, my mom and dad are buried here. I go and visit them once a year. Feels like my future's in the rearview mirror. Man, I'm so out of here. Whoa, I'm so sick of this town. Whoa, I'm so sick of this town. And when I go, I won't turn back around. You see, I'm so sick of this. I'm so sick of this. I'm so sick of this town.
Hey. Michael McDermott, I'm going to assume you're not, you don't mean Indianapolis.
I don't, not yet, but I've only been here for an hour. So yeah. give it time.
I'll give it time, all right. It's such a pleasure to have you, man.
Yeah, it's great to be back. I haven't been here in a lot of years. You know, I made a mess of my life, and things are looking up again, so it's good to be back.
Well, okay, so I want to talk a little bit about that. So you don't strike me as the kind of person who would name drop, so I'm going to do it for you.
Okay.
I
thought you don't seem like a person who would make a mess of things, but I was like, I know, right?
We can all do that, right? We're all capable of that kind of thing. So Matt Damon's character in the movie Rounders, based on you, I don't want to talk about that, but it's an interesting fact. The other name I want to drop is author Stephen King, big fan of yours. Mm-hmm. He's written about you. You became friends with him.
Yes.
And he wrote you a letter, I believe, what was it, 1995, that you carried around with you for 19 years before you heeded what it said. What was the letter?
Wow, that just gave me goosebumps. Yeah, I didn't.
So, yeah, he wrote me a letter. He's a recovering addict and alcoholic, and he had written me in the early part of my spiral. And so I carried this letter around, and really it was... For me, it was a type of currency, because then I can go to crack houses and go, like, look at Stephen King wrote me. You know, like, it was like, it was a currency. Like, I'm not as bad as you losers, you know, and because I know a famous guy. And that's kind of what it was. So I'd read it, and we'd all kind of marvel at the language that he used about recovery. So anyway, I carried this thing around, really, for all the wrong reasons. And I read it a million times, and after long runs of, you know, not sleeping, I'd read it and weep in the early morning hours. And but anyway, so when I finally got sober on January 14th of 2014.
Congratulations.
Thank you. And I read the letter again, and I thought, Jesus Christ, like, it was all right here. It was, you know, but I read it for all the wrong reasons. You know, I'd read it to be a braggart, you know. And but it was beautiful what he had written, and it was all true. And, you know, I just read it as some kind of a trophy, and I didn't listen, you know, and that's, we do that a lot of times, you know, even, you know, if you're in a marriage, you realize you hear things, but you're not listening, or you're listening and not hearing, you know, so that was the lesson, and it was terrible, because then I looked at the date of it, and it was, you know, 17 years or whatever, it was, you know, some gross amount of time that, you know, had I just not been such a moron and really just heeded what he had written, my life would be different. But, you know, it's all the way it was supposed to be, I guess.
Well, I'm glad that it's still going well.
Thank you.
And I want to talk about the current music, the new stuff that you're putting out. I mean, you are kind of really beautifully illustrating the current moment with this new music.
Thank you.
It's really, really something. And I don't know if you could take all the messages from your new songs and boil them down to a singular central message, which I know will be hard to do. What do you think you want the world to know about your perspective?
Well, yeah, that it's never, you know, I was desperate, and I was talking to Chris earlier. Like, there was a time where I wanted out, you know, and nothing was working. And, you know, I wasn't centered, you know, and we all try to balance ourselves with whatever it is, social media or food or sports or basketball or whatever. We all try to find things to even ourselves out because we're not always steady. The message, if anything, if the only thing I wanted to get across, and I could, it's a great segue, I'll go into this next song, but it's just to never give up, because it was all over for me, all over, without question. And it's not. As long as there's hope, there's always a chance, you know.
Michael McDermott, thanks for coming to Sun King
Studio. Thank
you.
Thanks for having me.
Let's hear a few more songs.
Okay.
Down again, I got back to my feet before they counted 10. I was burned out and busted from my rambling, bitching about all the things I could have been. Yeah, I was still drinking then. Here I am, counting all the ways that I screwed up again, beaten and battered from a bitter wind, waiting for that ship never coming in. Yeah, I was still drinking then. Yeah, but times have changed. I never felt at ease, never felt my age. I was always in a daze, and looking back, it's plain to see this ain't the life I thought it'd be. So when the road starts getting rough, don't give up no matter what. Things were crazy, man. I was burning bridges, breaking things I couldn't mend, starting wars and digging holes to fall down in, getting down in beds I should have never been. Yeah, I was still drinking then. I was dodging cars, running across a turnpike to another bar, stumbling in like just another falling star, caught right in the middle of a whirlwind. Yeah, I was still drinking then. Yeah, but times have changed. I never felt at ease, never felt my age. I was always filled with rage, and looking back, it's plain to see this isn't who I was meant to be. One day at a time, they say, a platitude, I know, cliche, but when you feel you've had enough, don't give up no matter what. I was an alien. I was snorting and shooting into oblivion, watching it like a movie someone else was in. I just couldn't see the shape that I was in. I was still drinking then. Yeah, then something changed. Right through the darkness came a brighter day. Felt like I was saved, and looking back, it's plain to see it's a hard life living on your knees. But even when you feel you're cursed, things can always get a little worse. Believe me. So don't give up no matter what. 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 You're worth it. Yeah, you're worth it. Yeah, you're worth it. Yeah, you're worth it. So don't give up no matter what. 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 You're worth it. Thank you.
All right, this is a song I'm going to do for my father. My father used to, he had the nickname Johnny Diversi because he parked cars on Clark and Diversi and used to park them for some gangsters and stuff, and they'd have him hold guns and stuff when he was just a kid. You know, it was a different time. He had this, I don't know, for whatever reason, even if I was on the road, I'd come home to see him unannounced, and I'd pull into the driveway and I'd see his shadow, like, in the window. Not like in Psycho, the mom in the top thing, but more welcoming than that. But yeah, he always seemed to know, like there was some sixth sense, and we had a very kind of typical Irish father son relationship, which to translate for those non-Irish means there was no relationship really. We loved each other, just kind of coexisted, and it was funny after, well, it wasn't funny, but after my mom died, and then I was kind of given the task of taking him to breakfast every morning, and it was became so nerve-wracking for him because I had such little to say to him. I would, like, you know, look at the internet for, like, topical stories and go out, you know, just to be like, hey, Dad, a Malaysian plane went down, just disappeared. It was just like, this, could we get the check? But it was every day, and it was, you know, it was so brutal. It'd be like going out on a bad date with the same person over and over and over and over again. But I loved him. He loved me, and I think, you know, I had a tendency to rewrite history a little bit, but anyway, we weren't too expressive, and this is called Shadow in the Window. So yeah, after he died, I went back, and it was like the first time in my life when I pulled into the driveway that he wasn't in that window, and it was, you know, it shook me.
So I took a drive over to his house, though I knew he wasn't there. And he was always standing looking out the window, or sitting in his easy chair. He was always a bit of a mystery. He always seemed so far away. Even when he was standing next to me,
We never had that much to say. He would always hear me coming or going from a million miles away. And I'd see his silhouette in the window every time I pulled out of the driveway. Now there's a shadow in the window that's missing. There's a shadow in the window that's gone. I only want to tell you I love you, and I'm doing my best to be strong and hold on. Yeah, I always wondered what he was thinking. Was he waiting for me to crash? Or maybe he just wanted to come with me, but I never thought to ask. And I always wondered what he was doing, watching me every time I drove away. And I wondered what he did that for. Maybe he just wanted me to stay. Now there's a shadow in the window that's missing. There's a shadow in the window that's gone. I only wanna tell you I love you, and I'm sorry that things went so wrong. And maybe I'll see you in heaven. At least that's how the story goes. Now there's a shadow in the window that's missing, and I'm having a hard time letting go. And maybe he felt like a prisoner bound by invisible chains, hidden all around. Yeah, he took more took out of him. He said, son, I want you to be so much better than me. Yeah, he told so many stories, I was never sure which ones were true. But he was too big for this small town. He was an Irishman through and through. And the bagpipes moaned on that cold day, the day we laid him to rest. But all I can say as I drive away, Dad, I'm sorry it came to this. Now there's a shadow in the window that's missing. There's a shadow in the window that's gone. I only want to tell you I love you, and I'm sorry that things went so wrong. And maybe I'll see you in heaven. At least that's how the story goes. Now there's a shadow in the window that's missing, and I'm having a hard time letting go. I love you, 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 I love you. Ooh, hey, I love you, 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 I do. Hey, I love you, 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 I love you. I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. Hey, Dad, I love you. Thank you. Yeah, I know a place. It's down in Texas. It's up near Fort Worth, called the Thorny Crown. And I was there in the late 90s when I was roving town to town. Now I'm not sure if it's still there. I kinda doubt it would be. I woke up that morning with blood on my pillow. Sometimes you need the chains to get free. Yeah, I know a place. It's in Mississippi, called Hal and Mal's. I think it's Tupelo. Or was it Jackson? Or maybe Biloxi? Or Tunica? Hell, I don't know. All I remember was this feeling that I wouldn't make it out of there alive. 'Cause sometimes you need the darkness in order to ever see the light. Yeah, so many miles I have traveled, so many a dim lit bar. 'Cause when things start to unravel, you're gonna find out who you are. You see, I know this place. It's on the Upper West Side. It's in New York City. The Dublin House, its name. I met a girl there on 9/11. Her name was Jill, or Judy, or Jane. And she was younger, she was wilder than me, and she thought she was smarter than just about everyone. But over a pint, she said round midnight, hey Michael, sometimes you gotta lose to know when you've won. Now I don't know why they call it Stanley's. It's in Chicago, and Donnie, he was the man. When I was struggling and I had no money, Donnie Cruz lended me his hand. 10 years later, I'm still working, providing for my daughter and my wife. 'Cause sometimes you need the darkness in order to ever see the light. Yeah, so many miles I have traveled, so many a dim lit bar. 'Cause when things start to unravel, you're gonna find out who your friends really are. Yeah, sometimes you gotta feed the darkness. Yeah, sometimes you'd better heed the darkness. Yeah, sometimes you're gonna need the darkness in order to ever see the light. Thank you. Should I do one more? Thank you, guys. Thanks for coming out during the day. Don't you people have jobs? But thanks for coming out. Thanks to everybody. It's been. This is a song that TTS played many years ago. It came out in 1991. And I figured this would be an appropriate song to sign off with. So thanks again, everybody.
are moving so fast that I couldn't comprehend it. I was first, maybe I was last. In confusion that descended, I was amazed by what had transcended down through the pages of time. Cause faith is a wall I must climb. And I was intrigued by your spirit and your eyes, which showed no pain. You were screaming, but I couldn't hear it. And your movements would not explain why you'd condemn me to my world of senseless rhyme. Cause fear is a wall I must climb. And I've seen some heroes in my day. I've seen the failures in yours. And I tried to connect us in some way. We were on two different shores. Though your love is worth millions of treasures, but I can't even spare a dime. Cause love is a wall I must climb. Yeah, and the people, they were singing. I could hear them from the street. And my feelings, they were stinging. I was submerged down in my defeat. But then I smiled for a second. Man, for that second, I felt just fine. Cause pain is a wall I must climb. And so quiet is the terror. Yeah, it swallows me like the night. And so quiet is my sickness. And these songs that I long to write. But I shall receive my passion eternally. From beyond the bitter stars that shine. Cause doubt is a wall I must climb. World of convergence, I'm a prisoner only unto me. Well, I wait for the emergence of the form I shall soon be. Till then I wait in the museum of my mind. Fate is a wall I must climb. And the hangman, he's in the shadows and he's looking for something to do until we find who won the battles of the evil and the true. And the judge is there in recess until they receive some sort of sacred sign. Belief is a wall I must climb. And have you ever looked at your face so much until it became askew? Cause the road that's less traveled is the one that leads right back to you. And Lord, I'm frightened, for I fear that my lack of life, it is my crime. I am a wall I must climb. And as we sail into the mystic, thank you very much, everybody.
Oh, Michael McDermott just cooking that harmonica, man.
Thank you.
Love hearing that one again. And Waterworks every time I hear Shadow in the Window. Thank you so much for playing that one. And thank you for coming to Sun King Studio 92.
Thank you. It's my honor.
Powered by Klipsch speakers and headphones. Once again, for Michael McDermott, please.
Thanks, everybody.